On my dad's side of the family, I am the oldest of 15 cousins. When I was growing up, 30 of my relatives would gather at my grandparents' house for holidays. That's far too many people to fit around one table. So as you can imagine, we set up two tables, the adults' table and the kids' table. My family is far from the only family to come up with this clever solution. I could almost feel you nodding your head as you think about the two tables at your own family gatherings. At my grandparents', the adults ate in the dining room. As you can see in this picture, we kids ate in the TV room. The adults sat at the fancy dining room table. We sat around card tables. The adults ate off nice china. We ate off paper, or if we were lucky, plastic plates. The adults actually had and used napkins, cloth napkins at that. We had our shirt sleeves. They had pleasant conversation. Somehow our conversation usually degenerated into throwing rolls at each other and a jello snorting contest. In theory, we were at the same meal. In reality, we had two very different experiences. That sounds a lot like how adults and kids experience church today. The adults' table is in the nicer, bigger room, and the kids' table is down the hall. Most churches have adult pastors and youth pastors, adult worship services and student services, adult mission trips and student trips. Do 16-year-olds need time to be together and on their own? You bet. But one of my mantras is that balance is something we swing through on our way to the other extreme. And I'm afraid that's exactly what's happened here. In our effort to offer relevant and developmentally appropriate teaching, we have segregated kids, and I do not use that verb lightly, but we have segregated kids from the rest of the church. And that segregation is causing kids to shelve their faith.